I was close to turning 18 by then and wanted to finish my quest before my birthday.
My quest? Dude, she's acting like she's playing a video game. She's acting like she's playing BitLife, but in real life. Ladies and gentlemen, I come bearing bad news. Yes, that's right. Our beloved Flavia from My Story Animated, which we all know famously had tid kids at age 18, has now been dethroned. Let's all take a moment of silence now. Okay, enough. Why has she been dethroned, you asked? Well, Storytime Animated came out with an animation. We have reacted to their channel a few times before, and they came out with 18 kids at 18. I'm addicted to having kids. Flavia is rolling over in her grave right now, surrounded by her 10 kids. It's very sad, actually. So we're gonna react to this animation. Check out Storytime Animated once again, as always, all right? They're awesome, so check them out. You guys have been asking me to react to this one, so that's what we're gonna do, all right?
Hi, my name is Tessa, and this might sound crazy, but by the time I turned 18, I already had 18 kids.
It doesn't sound crazy. It is crazy. Please seek some help, all right? And before we really get into this, I want to say, and it's important to say this because last time when I did the 10 kids reaction, some of you guys didn't like my opinions that I said about people that have too many kids. Remember that everything I say in these videos is just my opinion. You don't have to take it to heart. I'm sure there are some people out there that have had 10 kids by 18. I don't know. Do I personally think it's a responsible thing to do? Not at all. And there's many reasons for that. But I just want to say, you do you. I'm not trying to say that you're stupid or you have a bad life or whatever. I mean, hey, you could be filthy rich, you know? As long as your kids are supported, I don't care what you do.
You might ask yourself how that is even possible. I mean, there's not enough time in the year to get to be a mother of 18 before I can even buy alcohol, right? Well,
she made my point.
And I couldn't possibly be happier. Let me tell you a bit about myself. I grew up in a big family with lots of other children. I'm the youngest of 10 brothers and sisters.
So we have some nice backstory.
So you can imagine how busy my family home was.
Did we get a first name? Is that her? What's her first name? I need to know her name. Tell me who she is. With a gal with this many kids at age 18, I need to know her name.
My name is Tessa. And
Tessa. Yes. Hi, Tessa.
I'm the youngest of 10 brothers and sisters. So you can imagine how busy my family home was. Everyone was always meddling in each other's business.
They're all different colors. All of them. Dude, it's your mom, though. Can we not acknowledge that this is a problem? Right? To have, like, 10 different dads. Like, you all have the same mom, right? Maybe I'm jumping the gun, but she didn't say anything about being adopted or anything.
Everyone was always meddling in each other's business. And though it was sometimes
they just stand around the living room.
We really loved each other. And no, we are not some creepy religious cult or anything like that. My mom and dad are super normal people who are just used to big, happy families. They each have lots of siblings of their own and loved the idea of having many sons and daughters.
And this is the part where you tell me that they're adopted because one of them's black. Their parents are not black. So unless they're adopted, I mean, if you're not going to say this, I'm going to have to throw your credibility out the window.
So not only did I have all those older brothers and sisters, but also aunts and uncles and cousins. So many of them. It was amazing. And we all had so much fun together. You can only imagine how our family reunions go. To me, having many children was...
I was waiting for it and they never said it. You know, I'm just saying, based on skin tones, he looks at least Mexican. She looks probably Asian, you know? We got paper white girl over here and regular white people. I'm just saying, it's a little weird.
They each have lots of...
They are not adopted, apparently.
You can only imagine how our family reunions go.
Yeah, they gotta rent out a stadium just to get the family reunion going.
To me, having many children was super normal, and that was what I wanted to do. So when I met Tommy in middle school, I knew I had found the love of my life, even if we were both super young. He was really smart and funny and
so cute. Wait, pizza together?
He also came from a big family, just like my own.
Well, really?
A bit smaller. They were 7 siblings.
And all of his... Okay, he's got a very small... Why are these kids so big? They're all also different colors, all of them. I think there's a cheating conspiracy going on that no one's, like, fessing up to because that's gotta be it.
Instead of 11, but that was a lot more than many families, you know?
Woo.
What's funny is that he was the youngest, just like me. We had so much in common, and we both agreed that having big, happy families was the best. We began dating almost immediately.
So they're both on board. Good, right?
It didn't take us long to find ways of being together all alone. Well, as you might guess, one...
We are a place where creative dreamers...
What's going to happen? I'm not a fortune teller, but I think they're going to have... children.
...led to another, and soon I became pregnant. My mom and dad weren't super happy about it, since they wished I would have waited a bit longer. That being said...
Just imagine that talk, right? There would be such big hypocrites. You should not have been pregnant. Well, I would like to live my life. You know, I do want to have a bunch of kids, but I would like to also live my life. Like, if you're gonna have that many kids, you better have them all together as close as you can, or else you will literally be raising kids for the rest of your life. And I know what you say, right? When you raise kids, you don't really ever stop raising them. But there comes to a point where you're gonna actually want to do something for yourself and not constantly have a baby on your arms like this all the time. So of course they gotta start early. That's the only way this is gonna work. The parents are such big hypocrites. We had 40 children, what the heck?
They loved the idea of having a baby in the house again. To our surprise, it was not just a single baby.
Triplets!
But
of course.
Three. Yes, I had triplets. Tommy was super supportive about it, and he promised to help me take care of our babies.
You know how expensive baby formula is? Like, this is when I talk about this, this is what I'm talking about. Diapers, baby formula, the doctor's visits, if you have freaking healthcare, the tax write-offs. Ooh. Some people really want a lot of children because they want a lot of children. Other people really love tax write-offs, and they love big checks. I ain't saying everyone does that, but there are some people out there that do it.
He kept his word, and we continued dating. I was so in love with him, and we adored our three sons.
Look at the little
tax
write-offs.
It was so perfect that I asked myself, why not have even more babies?
Why? I need more.
I didn't tell my mom and dad about my plan.
I'll never get a week of sleep ever again.
Exactly agree. I did speak to Tommy, though, and he was super supportive. We were in high school by then, and this time around...
He's like, I got some left in the tank. I don't want any free time at all. Take it away. I'm so excited to not have any free time.
I didn't get pregnant by mistake. We absolutely were trying to have more babies.
Screw school. We don't need it.
It took us a bit longer to actually get pregnant, but that was okay. We were very busy with the triplets and our studies, so it wasn't as if we
were
desperate
studying
for it to happen.
Who's babysitting? You got all like five babysitters. Five of them. Just picture trying to sleep at night in this home. Even for the parents who live there as well. Constantly, at all hours of the night, I guarantee you, with this many kids, they will always be crying. Do you know how much poop? You know how much poop 18 babies could make? Too much. Let me tell you, you need a shovel.
I turned 15. I began feeling sick in the mornings. I knew those symptoms all too well, and
because I've had already 10 kids by now.
I rushed to the pharmacy to get myself a pregnancy test. I was so happy when it turned out to be positive, and I called Tommy at once.
Sorry, I just don't agree with this.
We celebrated that night and could already imagine another.
They went disco dancing. How'd you have time? How'd you have time to disco dance?
The problem was, it wasn't just one baby this time around either.
What?
Yes,
surprise.
You guessed it. It was
more triplets.
But now we had three.
Yahtzee! And this couple should go to the casino. I bet you they have good luck. Come on, give me three babies. I mean, three sevens.
Girls. It was so perfect. I couldn't even understand how we could be so lucky. My mom and dad didn't really scold me this time around, if I'm perfectly honest. They sort of assumed that I knew what I was doing by then and accepted that they were going to...
Okay, this baby is so freaking huge. You're telling me this is normal? Bro, this one's gonna eat the other ones. In fact, he's staring at me. I think I'm in danger.
They've had so many kids by now that they're starting to mutate. We are starting to get an evolved species of perfect baby. You know, this one fought its way out. That one came out.
Mama!
Have three more grandchildren to love and spoil. They decided that since Tommy and I already
had
so
enough rooms in your house,
how
many cribs?
It was better if we had a place.
How many cribs you need?
After the six babies, they had us move into the guest house at the back. Yes, as you might have guessed, my family was well off. It wasn't as if we were crazy rich or anything like that, but
they just
we
got
did
lots
all right.
of money from the government.
Tommy's parents were far richer than we were, honestly. He asked his dad to let him work at the family business to support me and the babies, and my father-in-law said yes. Tommy was young, like 16 at that time, but he was so bright and inventive, he did really well there. He began adding new ideas and improving the business.
Shut up! No one that has this many kids is gonna be going off to college just having so much time. If they even manage to get to college, they're gonna probably be asleep because, again, they never got sleep unless they wear freaking earphones. It's ridiculous.
And in no time, he was actually making the company earn even more money. That was cool because it meant that he could actually pay for the diapers and the formula, as well as pretty clothes for all our sons and daughters. When I got pregnant for the third time, I knew that I had to stop going to school.
It's triplets. It's quadruplets. Maybe we'll get quadruplets this time.
I simply didn't have the time to do it all at once. Don't be thinking I'm a high school dropout or something like that, though. I totally graduated and ahead of time to boot. I just studied from home. Basically, I was homeschooled in a way, but I studied on my own.
I just picture they got their babies to do math. We don't need to count our fingers. We'll just use the babies. Every example sentence, instead of, like, you know, in math, how they say, oh, you got 20 pineapples in a shopping cart. They just got babies and they just, like, took them away, you know, like, if I have 10 kids and I take away 5, how many do I have? You know, things like that.
Didn't need any tutor to tell me to sit down and read a book. Tommy decided to go to college after he graduated, but chose one that was super close to home so that he wouldn't have to be away too often.
How convenient!
He began working from his study in the guest house, and so he could really help me with all the babies. You might be asking yourself if my third pregnancy resulted in triplets again.
Four.
But it wasn't one either. It was twins, a girl and a boy.
Wow, maybe next time we'll get more.
All the time. I'm not going to lie.
How disappointing.
But at the same time, I didn't want to stop. I wanted to have more and more children. Sure, I could have simply gotten pregnant again, but that sort of seemed a bit selfish. There are so many...
How is it selfish? Oh, I get it. Oh, so are they finally adopting?
Children in this country, and I felt like I could both expand my beautiful family
Seriously?
And give children without a home a loving mom and dad, as well as lots of siblings.
Look, I don't have any kids, you know, and I'm not sure if I will. I mean, I most likely will, eventually. But, like, I think adopting is such a, like, it's such a, just the whole idea of it is such a good one. You know, it's not as fun to do, probably, as far as, like, starting it out, I'm sure. And there's probably a lot of adoption, like, process, like the papers and things like that. But, I mean, I've talked to people that have adopted and, you know, it's such a rewarding feeling because, again, yeah, there's so many kids out there that don't have homes and their parents were freaking screw-ups, you know? Not all of us can have perfect parents like these ones that can have as many babies as they feel like. It's still have a full-time job and 10 years of education while never missing a day.
So I spoke to Tommy about my idea and he absolutely loved it. But he told me that before he wanted to buy me a big house.
How many rooms?
Paperwork to get us in the list to adopt orphan kids, he searched for a perfect house to raise our huge family.
They're gonna buy a
in.
Mansion. They gotta move into like Jeffree Star's mansion. That's the only way they're gonna, their kids are gonna have any room.
We already had 8 biological children, and I was determined to adopt 10 more. It was not an easy task.
Why? You're not running a farm.
To achieve it.
It's not a farm.
Now, don't be thinking I just laid on my bed and let some nanny raise my kids. I was a full-time mom who dedicated herself to her beautiful, bright children. I loved them with all my heart, and they kept me so busy through the day.
Toys you gotta buy?
Just when the adoption papers
keep going.
Began to be approved, Tommy let me in on the good news. He had managed to get a loan from his dad to buy the perfect home. He was doing really well for himself by that time, and his father knew that we'd be able to pay him back. My mom and dad were so proud of
$14 million a year,
adopting all those poor boys and girls, and they supported us 100%.
I'm sorry, but like, you go to an adoption center, and you tell them I have 8 kids and I want to adopt 10 more. I want more babies. You think they're gonna let you do that? No, not any smart people. Not any smart people. I don't think that they would let you do that. I think it's a pretty big process in order to adopt somebody.
We flew all around the country to find children to adopt, and we knew that it would be best if
their kids had to take half the seats.
Babies were what everyone wanted, but if we adopted 3 to 5 year olds, then we'd be giving homes to kids that people turn their backs on. The kids were all super shy, and they struggled to adapt to their new home. I couldn't blame them.
I mean,
after all, they had abandoned once
already.
They had
no peace.
They were probably scared to be sent back if they made too much noise or something. But Tommy and I encourage them to open up and feel safe with us and their brothers and sisters.
Why don't they open their eyes to me more? They're like, oh, we're so tired because none of us got any sleep. There was so much crying in this house. Please take me back.
Soon they were laughing and playing as if they had always been a part of our family. I was close to turning 18 by then and wanted to finish my quest before my birthday.
My quest? Dude, she's acting like she's playing a video game. She's acting like she's playing BitLife, but in real life.
It'd be the best gift in the world for me. So we got on another plane while my mom and dad took care of all our children.
Why do you need that many kids? Just play BitLife.
Tommy and I visited so many places and finally managed to find the 5 perfect additions to our growing family. They were all so
sweet
and in need of a mom and dad who would love them unconditionally. These new kids were super timid as well, but the fact that there were already so many other adopted children in the house made their adaption period far easier. I couldn't believe that my dream to have a big, happy family had finally become a reality. You can't even imagine how busy my day is, running around the house with 18 kids to take care of.
Why these ones never grow up? I guess these are new ones, but they look the same as the other ones. Dude, she had so many kids that the animator got tired of drawing all of them.
I wouldn't change it for the world, though. I couldn't be happier. And Tommy continues to work from home, so he can always be there to give me a helping hand. He's doing super well financially.
Yeah, baby hands. That's so much babies. I got baby hands.
Buy lots of nice toys and clothes for all our children. You might ask yourself if I ever show my biological kids that I love them more. And the answer is no, never. I couldn't even imagine doing anything so cruel. I love all my sons and daughters equally. I don't care if I got pregnant with them or if they have a different biological mother and father. Me and Tommy, they are all equally ours. My mom and dad and my in-laws adore all of their grandkids as well. You can only imagine how much fun they all have when it's time to go pay them a visit. That's how I managed to be the mom of 18 kids by the time I was 18. I'm thinking that in a few years, perhaps Tommy and I will adopt 4 or 5 more children.
Shut up! No, you did not just say that. I think Flavia and her family should go have a war with this family, and we'll see which the best babies survive. With the best kids win, you know? I think it'd be a pretty sick battle. Although Flavia would be outnumbered, you know? Flavia is shaking in her boots right now. They're gonna have so many kids that they don't even need a car anymore. They can just get the kids to carry the parents wherever. it's like an army. They're building an army. They're gonna rise up one day. We need to put a stop to this.
But we haven't really begun discussing it seriously. I love having such a big family and helping my sweet babies. I know that the ones we adopted might never have found a good mom and dad otherwise, and seeing them smile is the biggest reward I could ask for.
How many toilets do you got in that house? Their private car is probably a bus. That's what I'm saying. When they go to the movies, they gotta reserve at least 20 seats. Could you imagine that? They're gonna reserve so many seats that they can't even sit next to each other. Some of the kids have gotta be in the front row watching a movie like this. Have you ever sat in the front row of movie seats? Awful! And that's abuse right there. If you ask me, that's abuse. Today's quip of the day goes to Ravenclaw Daniela. Squib, squib!